This segment brought to you by Kansas Corn. Learn more at kscorn.com.
Welcome back. Now let's see what Kyle and Duane are discussing today on Plain Talk.
Coming down in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, this is Kyle Bauer with Plain Talk with Duane Allen Toews.
Kyle Bauer, your fact or fiction question of the day. In Antarctica, there's a glacier called Blood Falls. Fact or fiction?
I've heard of Blood Falls, I think.
You think?
But I don't know where it is. So seeing how I've heard of Blood Falls and I don't know where it is, I'm going with true. It's in Antarctica.
It is in Antarctica. The glacier regularly pours out a red liquid, a result of oxidized salt water.
Really? And I thought maybe it was bacteria.
No, oxidized salt water. Actually, looks like the glacier is bleeding.
Have you ever seen the red snow in the mountains? In the summer, you'll go up there and you'll see red snow.
No, I've seen brown snow on the plains.
Yeah. You've seen yellow snow.
I've seen yellow snow.
Right. But right. No, and they say you don't go anywhere eating that. I mean, that's a bacteria.
Really?
That grows on that snow. So
bacteria growing
on snow.
That's a bit odd.
Maybe it's an algae.
Oh.
An algae? Yeah. Well, I don't know. They say don't.
A fungus among us.
Yeah, exactly. You need to use athlete's foot on your snow prior to eating it. Athlete's foot spray.
Tear down really good.
Did you know that the major fungicide that we use on wheat was discovered as a great fungicide on wheat? It was originally developed for athlete's foot.
No.
I swear, I was at their laboratory one day, and the guy that discovered it was still working there.
Really?
And he said, yeah, I developed this for athlete's foot. Turns out it works on...
Pretty good on...
on the fungus on your wheat. And they don't even call it athlete's wheat.
Athlete's wheat.
No, they don't even call it that.
You know, it's amazing. Those people that tinker with different combinations of...
Chemistries
to come up with stuff. Like one of the ones that was fairly prevalent was found in the ground on the tailing behind a distillery somewhere.
Yeah, I heard that story too. They realized that there was nothing growing there, and
let's dig up some of that and put it in a test tube and see what we got.
Well, the guy that discovered the microwave oven. He was trying to work on x-rays, and he had a chocolate bar in his pocket.
Ah.
And melted his chocolate bar.
And so, that'll leave us.
Yeah, and it's like, wait a minute. Maybe we could use this for something other than what we were really trying for.
Quick heating,
yeah, exactly. In July the 8th, 1776, the great peal of the Liberty Bell alerted citizens that the country they lived in was now independent, while the Founding Fathers read to them the Declaration of Independence that freed them from tyranny from British rule. But the story just doesn't really ring true.
The timeline's not working.
Doesn't really work. It is true that the bell was hanging in Philadelphia at the State House at the time, but no one rang it. I mean, think about this. They were all committing treason.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't they? Well, it had a huge crack in it from a forging error even then.
And
it was not a symbol of freedom or liberty. It was a sign of bad workmanship. No, the name, the Liberty Bell, wasn't adopted until 1839.
That's a fair piece later.
In a pamphlet put out by the Philadelphia Tourism Committee.
Well, you got to draw in.
The Liberty Bell by Friends of Freedom, where it symbolized the liberty of black slaves, not the independence of white Americans from Britain. Now, how in the world did we get the story that wrong for that long?
Thanks for joining us. I'm your host, Jamie Bloom, and I hope you enjoyed today's show. See you next week on Farm Factor.
Closed captioning brought to you by Ag Promo Source. Together we grow. Learn more at agpromosource.com.